group of women civil society organizations have filed pressure on government to reconsider the decision to merge Uganda Women's Entrepreneurship Program, UWERK, with other health creation funds to form a pool of revolving funds to finance the parish development model. The women's government condemned the, the women's movement condemned the plan and expressed fears that it will disadvantage women who have been benefiting from the affirmative action of the women centric. We have more on this report.
The women's movement of Uganda today expresses its dismay and concern at the proposal to merge UWEP with the other eight funds.
The government's decision to merge the Uganda Women Entrepreneurship Program with other wealth funds to finance the parish development model has stirred an uproar from women activists. Today, groups of women activists addressed the press in Kampala and condemned the plan.
The proposed parish development model as presented by the minister is right now glaringly silent on gender dynamics that come into play in the distribution of economic resources to women. Women's ability to obtain economic resources is characterized by challenges such as limited access to affordable credit, limited technical knowledge and skills for business development, limited access to markets, as well as information regarding business opportunities.
This is an important, though unintended, effect on social norms surrounding women's participation in business that the project has had on our society. UWEP has been lauded as one of Uganda's successes in regards to the implementation of the Beijing Platform for Action of 1995.
The women's movement is also concerned that consolidating Uganda Women Entrepreneurship Program is to disadvantage women because the parish model is not gender sensitive. They claim the new fund doesn't have special consideration to women empowerment, which will derail women and their projects.
Defeats the very purpose for which the women-centric UWEP was created, and that is to improve access to financial services for women and equipping them with skills for enterprise growth, value addition, and marketing of their products and service. The program, being women focused, takes into account the status of women and the unique barriers they face accessing credit and capital.
Led by Elizabeth Biaruhanga Adriko, the executive director of FIDA, women tasked the government with maintaining the UWEP as an independent fund.
This merger will debase the progress that has already been made. Our call to action is as follows: that the Uganda Women Entrepreneurship Program must be maintained as an independent women-centric initiative under the supervision of Ministry of Gender, Labour and Social Development. Government should increase the resource allocation and technical support under the program to allow the program to meet the overwhelming demand.
CSOs including UONET, FIDA, UOPA and FOWODE, among others, want the government to review the implementation of the parish development model before it takes effect.
The government should strengthen its monitoring unit to address the systemic barriers associated with the management of this fund. We call on government to re-evaluate the implementation of the proposed parish development model to make it more gender responsive and transformative for the lives of its intended beneficiaries.
But according to the State Minister for Planning, David Bahati, taking wealth creation funds to the parish level will give women more access to more credit than before, since funding is going to increase. He disclosed that 30% of the parish model funds will be reserved for women, which guarantees an affirmative action.
Now UWEP has been getting 32 billion, but with a new model of the parish model, which now we have allocated 400 billion to the parish model. So if you refer 30% to the women, it means that now the women will be getting 120 billion against the 32 billion which they have been getting. And the other program of monitoring evaluation can go on as has been.
According to statistics from the Ministry of Gender, Labour and Social Development, 11,256 projects and 190,825 vulnerable women have benefited from UWEP. This story was compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News in Parliament.